Inflammatory bowel disease, abbreviated as IBD, is the name for a group of conditions that cause the digestive system to become inflamed, that is, red, swollen, and sometimes painful. Your digestive system runs from your mouth to your anus. If your digestive system is healthy, food moves smoothly through your digestive system and out of your body. Your body absorbs the nutrients it needs from the food. The rest passes through your body and leaves as urine or stool. If you have IBD, part of your digestive system is inflamed. Over time, the inflammation can cause severe pain, diarrhea, and sometimes bloody stools. IBD symptoms come and go in episodes or flares. Because of the inflammation in your digestive system from IBD, your body cannot absorb all of the nutrients it needs. This can lead to malnutrition, other symptoms of IBD, or other health problems such as anemia. The most common types of IBD are ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease. The diseases are similar but affect different parts of the digestive system. Ulcerative colitis affects the large intestine and rectum. The disease causes swelling and tiny open sores or ulcers on the surface of the lining of large intestine or rectum. The ulcers can bleed and produce pus. With ulcerative colitis, there is continuous area of damage along the large intestine and rectum rather than patches of damage. Crohn's disease can affect any part of the digestive system from the mouth to the anus. Inflammation in Crohn's disease often happens in patches on digestive organs such as stomach or intestines. With Crohn's, there is normal tissue next to an inflamed area or patches of damage. More than 3 million people in the United States have IBD. IBD is more common in people who are over age 45. IBD affects women in unique ways. IBD can cause more menstrual symptoms. Women with IBD are more likely to experience premenstrual symptoms such as headache and menstrual pain. Iron deficiency anemia. The risk of iron deficiency anemia is higher for women who have IBD than for the women who do not have IBD. If you have IBD, your body may not absorb iron well, and you have a higher risk of bleeding in the digestive system. Trouble getting pregnant. During a flare-up of your IBD symptoms, you may have trouble getting pregnant. The symptoms of IBD are often similar for ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease. Symptoms include diarrhea, often loose and watery with Crohn's disease, or bloody with ulcerative colitis, severe or chronic cramping pain in the abdomen, loss of appetite leading to weight loss, fatigue, fever, rectal bleeding, joint pain, skin problems such as rashes. Symptoms can range from mild to severe. Your symptoms can sometimes go away for months or even years, called remission, before coming back, called a flare-up. Researchers do not know exactly what causes IBD. The body's immune defense system may trigger IBD. Usually, the immune system protects the body from infectious viruses or bacteria. Once the infection is gone, that part of the immune system shuts off until it is needed again. But in people with IBD, the immune system may overreact to normal bacteria in the digestive system. Once the immune system starts, it does not shut off when it should. Over time, this leads to inflammation, which damages the digestive system. While researchers do not know why IBD starts, some studies suggest that the risk of developing IBD may be higher for women who have antibiotics, birth control pills, or non-steroidal anti-inflammatories such as aspirin or ibuprofen. Stress does not cause IBD, but it may make IBD symptoms worse. Some tests used to diagnose IBD include blood test, colonoscopy or sigmoidoscopy, upper endoscopy, small bowel follow-through, computerized axial tomography, CT scan or magnetic resonance enterography, capsule endoscopy. Treatments for IBD may include medicines, surgery, changes to your eating habits, some forms of psychotherapies, sometimes called talk therapy, may also help you cope with stress related to IBD symptoms and help make your pain less severe. Your doctor may give you medicines to control inflammation such as aminosalicylates, which may also help prevent flare-ups. Most people with mild to moderate ulcerative colitis and some people with Crohn's disease are treated with aminosalicylates, biological therapies which block substances in your body that cause inflammation, antibiotics which may help if you have an infection or overgrowth of bacteria, medicines to calm your immune system such as corticosteroids, which are strong, fast-acting drugs to treat IBD flare-ups. You will take these for short periods of time only. If taken for too long, corticosteroids can cause serious side effects including bone loss. Immunosuppressants, which can take up to 6 months to work. But unlike corticosteroids, immunosuppressants can be taken long-term to prevent flare-ups. More than half of people with Crohn's disease need surgery within 20 years of being diagnosed. Surgeries for Crohn's disease include bowel resection. In this surgery, your doctor removes the damaged part of your small or large intestine and sews the two healthy ends together. Removal of your large intestine, including your rectum. After this procedure, your body can no longer get rid of solid waste on its own. Your doctor will make a small opening in the front of your abdominal wall. Then your doctor will bring the end of your small intestine through the hole. This allows waste to drain out of your body. A pouch is worn over the opening to collect waste. You will need to empty the pouch several times a day. Fistula surgery. Some patients develop a collection of pus or drainage of pus from an opening around the anus. Surgery may be required to drain the pus and put it in a small wire to keep the pus from recollecting. Almost 1 in 3 people with ulcerative colitis may need surgery to treat the ulcerative colitis at some point. Your doctors will talk to you about steps you can take at home to relieve your IBD symptoms. Some steps may include reducing stress. Stress does not cause IBD, but it can make your IBD symptoms worse. Some studies show that mindfulness therapy, hypnotherapy, and psychotherapy may help. Changing your eating habits. Some women report that limiting or avoiding certain foods help relieve symptoms. Taking vitamin supplements. Your doctor may suggest vitamin supplements if your body does not get all of the nutrients you need from food because of IBD. You may need to take vitamin B12, folic acid, vitamin D, calcium or iron. Taking probiotics. Some research suggests that probiotics, which are live bacteria similar to what is found naturally in the body, may help some people with IBD. Probiotics are in foods such as yogurt that indicate that there are live and active cultures on the label. Probiotics also come as a supplement you can buy in many stores. IBD can lead to other health problems. Some of the conditions include iron deficiency anemia. Iron deficiency anemia happens when your level of healthy red blood cells, which carry oxygen to all the parts of your body, is below normal. This can happen because of blood loss from your digestive system. Dehydration or malnutrition, diarrhea and cramping pain can make it harder to eat or for your body to get the nutrients it needs. You may need an IV or feeding tube to replace lost fluids or nutrients. Toxic megacolon. Toxic megacolon happens when the large intestine swells quickly and stops working. Toxic megacolon is serious and can cause severe pain and even death. Colon cancer. Crohn's disease can raise your risk of colon cancer. Weak bones. Crohn's disease can cause bone loss and osteoporosis. Medicines to treat ulcerative colitis may also lead to bone loss. Inflammation inside your body. IBD can cause liver problems, gallstones, and pancreatitis. Kidney stones. Kidney stones are small, painful stones, sometimes formed from oxalate, a type of salt in the kidneys. They are more common in people with Crohn's disease. Some of the other health problems get better when IBD is treated. Some other health problems must be treated separately from IBD. Although these conditions are not necessarily caused by IBD, people with IBD are more likely to also have depression and anxiety, especially during flare-ups. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe our channel.